President of the meeting, Comrade Hemlata, General Secretary of your organization, Comrade Tapan Sen, our dear colleague in the Central Trade Unions platform, Comrade Michael, President of World Federation Trade Union, all my colleagues of Central Trade Union sitting on the dais, CITU leadership on the dais, all my brothers, sisters, delegate comrades and media persons. Very many thanks to CITU leadership for giving us this privilege to greet the 16th Congress of CITU when you are observing 50 years of your national center. And we are observing 100 years of AITUC. And you have chosen very auspicious day to begin with, auspicious day to conclude with. Today is 23rd January, and on behalf of the dais and all of you, we all remember today is birthday of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. We salute him, a great freedom fighter. You are beginning your session on that day. Great occasion. And you are concluding on, I heard, on 26th January. Another great day. India became republic and our constitution was adopted. The constitution which is under attack. So you will be having your rally asserting that working class will not allow Indian constitution to be attacked. So many, many thanks for inviting me here. Comrades, your able leadership. Comrade Tapan has been working in parliament and outside. So he has experiences of both. And your leadership from your grassroots experience will definitely will be dealing all the issues which are there, which the working class is facing today. I don't want to dwell on that because you will have your report, you will have deep discussions from all your unions from different states with all India and international perspective. Of course, you will come out with programs of actions by your organization as well as to be taken forward in the United platform. But when I am standing here to greet you, I just want to say a few things. What do we think as working class? What has been our role in our country? And how we are going to face all the challenges which your leadership will inform you, which you yourself also know at the grassroots level, all those challenges which are before the working class. We have achieved certain status in the society through our struggles of almost 200 years struggle of assertion of workers in India. And I dare say today, on behalf of trade unions, I can dare say today that it was the workers of India, Adivasis of India, and the peasants of India who were the first people to revolt against British rule. And the revolt started beginning from 1820s. We are in 2020 today. The first strike recorded in Indian history is of 1823. It was the assertion of workers, Adivasis and farmers who stood against oppression and suppression and exploitation of Britishers. They created an environment in this country for freedom movement. I am not exaggerating. Main koi atishyokti nahi kar rahi, comrades, ke is desh ke mazdooron ne wo prishthbhumi aur wo bhumi ka tayar ki jiski wajah se angrezon ko chunauti dene ka rajneetik andolan is desh ke andar shuru ho saka. These are our roots. When we hold banners of our central trade unions and our own unions affiliated to our central trade unions, we have that background in our mind. We should have that background in our mind. 1857 ki first war of independence se pehle, workers ne wo bhumika tayar ki किस देश में वो पहला स्वतंत्रता संग्राम शुरू हो पाता. That 1857 war of independence was crushed by the Britishers, but it was again, once again, it was the workers who started asserting, and then after 50s they started unionizing themselves. One after another strikes were happening in plantation, by jute workers, by railways, by defense workers, by workers of all variety, whatever was there. They started asserting. By the end of 19th centuries, unions were there, cropped up unions. 19th sadi ka ant aate aate bahut si unions banna shuru hua. And by the beginning of 20th century, the process further increased. So in that background, Indian working class continuously not only inspired the political movement to be carried forward against British rule, it also strengthened the freedom movement. Apni mang, kaam ke ghante, social security, kaam ke daam, ek saman kaam ka vetan, hamari behno ke liye matritva labh, bachchon ko kaam ke sthan pe nahi hona, mazduri nahi karna, paathshala milna, right to descent, right to democracy, right to freedom of expression, right to strike, all those were issues. And in 20th century, thousands of strikes are recorded in history. Beginning from 1900 onwards, thousands of strikes are recorded in history, even before the national center, the first national center in 1920, at All India level, assimilating all the unions, all political thoughts, all directions, everybody coming together in the city of Bombay and having AITUC being founded with Lala Lajpat Rai as being its president. Before that, Indian working class had made a mark. Indian working class started giving directions even to the freedom movement. Bal Gangadhar Tilak ko giriftar kiya 1908 mein, to kya mazdoor sadkon pe kaam ke ghante ke liye aaye? Kya wo samajik suraksha ke liye aaye? Kya wo apne vetan ke liye aaye? Nahi. हिंदुस्तान की वर्किंग क्लास ने जगह जगह के ऊपर फैक्ट्रियों में आंदोलन करके सड़कें जाम की कि बाल गंगाधर तिलक को रिहा करो. वी वर सीमेंटिंग फैक्टर, द वर्किंग क्लास वाज सीमेंटिंग फैक्टर फॉर द फ्रीडम मूवमेंट ऑफ द कंट्री अगेंस्ट ब्रिटिश एम्पायर. इट वाज इन दैट बैकग्राउंड, आफ्टर बैकग्राउंड ऑफ जलियांवाला बाग कांड, द किलिंग ऑफ सेवरल हंड्रेड्स ऑफ पीपल इन जलियांवाला बाग, and then the non-cooperation movement going on in the country, that the first center came into being as AITUC. That heritage belongs to all of us who are sitting here. Before 1920 till 1947, all that working class movement and struggle is the heritage of which all of us take pride of. Not only AITUC talks about this. Isliye hamare ko aaj ye kehna zaruri hai. We got our rights, started getting our rights from British rulers. We got our right to Trade Union Act 1926 in 26. TU Act is 26. Our Compensation Act is 23. Our Factories Act we got in 1881. We got improvement in that act in 1921. We started getting our rights even from British Empire as a united movement. Not only that, we created a ground for political movement to take courage to ask the Britishers to leave this country, but working class of India gave direction also to the freedom movement. The political platform gave slogan in 1929 for complete independence, but in 1921, 8 years before that, the Indian working class in its second session of AITUC in Jharia passed a resolution of complete independence. So it's not exaggeration. Indian working class was even giving direction in which the freedom movement should move. I also want to say, it was the working class of this country which formed this charter of demand, which submitted that charter of demand to all parties. Delegation they went to all parties, group they went, and they said, this is what we would like to see. Once India gets free and we move forward for independent India, this is what we would like to see in the Indian Constitution. And if today, from this podium, you pass a resolution on CAA to defend Indian Constitution, and we take up those resolutions in our own forums also, are we saying something new? No. Our predecessors, हमारे बुजुर्गों ने, हमारे पुरखों ने इस देश के संविधान को बनाने में भूमिका अदा की है, उसको दिशा दी है. हमने राइट टू डिसेंट मांगा, हमने उसमें फ्रीडम ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन मांगा, हमने उसके अंदर काम के घंटे सुनिश्चित मांगे, हमने राइट टू एसोसिएशंस एंड यूनियंस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में हो हमने ये मांगा, हमने वहाँ लिविंग वेज मांगा, हमने वहाँ पर इस देश के अंदर डेमोक्रेसी और सेकुलरिज्म होना चाहिए इसकी बात रखी. सो इट इज नथिंग न्यू. देन इन अवर प्लेटफॉर्म्स वी टेक दिस अप. वी आर ओनली कैरिंग फॉरवर्ड द हेरिटेज ऑफ अवर वर्किंग क्लास ऑफ अवर कंट्री. एंड दैट इज व्हाई माय फ्रेंड्स, इन द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वी गॉट द राइट्स नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ मर्सी ऑफ सम पॉलिटिशियंस और मर्सी ऑफ दोज हु हैव बीन रूलिंग. इट वॉज हार्ड वन राइट्स by our working class struggle during freedom movement, before foundation of AITUC, after foundation of AITUC, then in independent India, even after several trade union centers being over there, independently and collectively, we fought and got all those rights. And present regime, Mr. Narendra Modi regime, wants to take us back to the British era. This is what you will be debating about. Your able leadership will be definitely telling you what all we have to do. Discuss about codification of labor laws, why it is dangerous. Discuss about why our public sector is put on sale. You will be discussing about the kind of economic policies which are reducing social sector spending. You will be discussing about the price rise situation and the job losses. How one after another our public sector has been put on sale. प्रॉफिट मेकिंग पब्लिक सेक्टर ऑल्सो, ये सब बेचने के लिए ये देश में चले हैं, ये जो हुकूमत बैठी है वो सब आप चर्चा करेंगे. लेकिन हमें जो सबक लेना है अपनी अपनी कॉन्फ्रेंसिस से, वो सबक ये लेना है कि वर्किंग क्लास हमेशा वैनगार्ड रही है, मजदूर वर्ग हमेशा अगली कतार में रहा है, हर संघर्ष में, राजनीति को दिशा दिखाने में भी, आंदोलनों को दिशा दिखाने में भी, लड़ाई के अंदर भी सबसे आगे होने में ये हमने रोल अदा किया है इतिहास में. और आज फिर हमको अपने ही आज़ाद हिंदुस्तान के अंदर अपने ही देश की आज़ादी को बचाने का प्रश्न खड़ा है, अपने देश के संविधान को बचाने का प्रश्न खड़ा हो गया है, अपने भाईचारे को बचाने का प्रश्न खड़ा हो गया है, सैकड़ों वर्षों की सांझी विरासत की सभ्यता को बचाने का प्रश्न खड़ा हो गया है. और हमारी वर्किंग क्लास को, हमारे फार्मर्स को, हमारे फाइटिंग सेक्शंस ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स को, यूथ को, इंटेलेक्चुअल्स को, नाटककारों को, फिल्मकारों को, किसानों को, सबको, इस पूरे समाज को बंटवारा करके ये अपनी इस देश को बेचने की पॉलिटिक्स को आगे बढ़ाना चाहते. सो माइंड इट कॉमरेड्स, दे आर डूइंग व्हाट ब्रिटिशर्स डिड. टू थिंग्स ब्रिटिशर्स डिड. वन वाज टू लूट दिस नेशन, एक्सप्लॉइट दिस नेशन, एंड अवर रिसोर्सिस बीइंग एक्सप्लॉइटेड, मनी बीइंग साइफंड ऑफ फ्रॉम दिस कंट्री. सेकेंड वाज, इफ यू कंटिन्यू, if you have to continue to exploit and to rule this country, you must divide the people. So divide and rule was their politics. Very same politics is being practiced by Modi government sitting in the center. Every time they bring dividing issue, underneath they are selling something of this nation. They are today surrendering our country to IMF and World Bank dictates. They want our economy to be dictated by international finance capital. That is the danger we are facing. Our sovereignty is under stake. Our natural resources are under stake. Our voice, our democracy, our secularism, everything is under stake. So two-pronged policy this government is doing. And they are also divide and rule politics, and underneath selling whatever Indian people built in this country. And that's why I have a limited time. Hemlata ji said, we speak in brief. That's why, in this brief, in nutshell, I want to say, friends, those who are ruling us there in Delhi, they were never the participants of Indian freedom movement. They were traitors of our freedom movement. Hamare Azadi ke dushman, Britishers ke dalal, wo aaj kursi pe baithe hain. Isiliye jo British samrajya ki niti thi, usi ke jariye se wo Hindustan mein raj karna chahte. They were exploiters and looters, and this government is only serving Adanis and Amanis or the international companies and international finance capital. They don't want to look at the people down below. And that is why, beginning from ghar vapsi, love jihad, gaye raksha, then Bharat Mata ki jai, then they remove 370, they convert Jammu Kashmir into jail, and now they have brought the CAA, NPR and NRC. They want to confuse people that census was there in this country, why you are opposed? Who is opposing census? None of us is opposing census. We have census from 1861 going on in this country. This is the 60th census which is supposed to take place in this country. Are we opposing it? No. We are opposing your amendment to Citizens Act, which was existing from 1955. You are muddling with that. You are dividing this country. You are threatening the people. You are creating a fear psychosis. And you are not only against minorities, you which you were always against, but you are against every poor person of any community, of any religious group, of any geographical area. Mr. Modi and Mr. Amit Shah, you don't value democracy. You believe in dictatorship. Your words are like that. It is not we who are accusing. You are founder. RSS founder Head Gwar clearly said they don't have quarrel with the British people. When he was asked then with whom you have quarrel, he said Muslims, Christians and red flag. This is what he said. It is not we who are telling jo Hitler ki chal chalega, wo Hitler ki maut marega. It is not slogan, something coming without nothing. It is Head Gwar, RSS founder. And who are they? They are RSS cadres. Modi, Amit Shah and their company. Head Gwar said, he said Hitler is their inspiration. Mussolini is their inspiration. Nazivad is their philosophy. Fasivad is their philosophy. Is it our allegation? No. It is the acceptance of your founder who said they believe in Hitler and they believe in Mussolini. They believe in fascism and they believe in Nazism. And that is how when Narendra Modi stands in Jharkhand, Jharkhand ke delegates yahan aaye honge. Kya bola wo chunav mein? Sharam nahi aati ek prime minister ko. ऐसी भाषा का प्रयोग करते हुए कि उसने कहा अरे जो CAA का विरोध कर रहे हैं उनको ड्रेस से पहचानो. What do you want to say? You want your Sangh Parivar to corner Muslim community? I must salute from your podium to our students of JNU, Jamia, Aligarh Muslim University, 90 university which came on the street to challenge this government. This younger generation is our hope. They are so afraid of that young girl, Aisha. They were so much afraid of Kanhaiya. So much afraid they are of these youngsters because they have rallied around them thousands and thousands of students on the streets. And that's why, day before yesterday, when Amit Shah said, Karlo tum virod, hum to andolan se hi paida hue hain, hum peeche nahi hatenge. एक बार कानून बन गया पीछे नहीं जाएगा. I want to tell them this is the language of dictator. This is the language of authoritarian. This is the language of a fascist. When people are moving on the streets, workers and farmers and students and teachers and intellectuals are on the streets, you say, बोलते रहो हमें कोई परवाह नहीं है. That means no, you do not respect the sentiments of our people. Vast majority are opposed to the CAA. You tried to divide them by attacking Jamia Millia when they were opposing CAA. Salute to those non-Muslim boys. They stood in the front rows of Muslim boys and girls and they said, we will face the bullets and lathis of the police. This is how our younger generation has shown one after another university that we will not be derailed. But in the end, I must tell you, my friends, once again, it was working class. It was all of us, these central trade unions. Modi was only 1 year and 3 months old in the government in 2015. First challenge to open the voice and to come on the streets was given by the working class, 2nd September 2015. We gave that courage to the people. He is not that he can't be attacked and he can't be defeated. We can take up this call and challenge this government. And we did it. People did not believe such a big strike will happen. It happened. Our number increased on 2nd September 2016. Our number further increased on 8th, 9th January 2019. Our number has surpassed 25 crore in 8th January 2020 strike. So the working class in the history played its role. The working class played the role in giving directions to the freedom movement also. Working class played role in framing of Indian constitution also. Working class in Indian context has been in the forefront giving that direction. And now also we are there in the forefront. Our all sectoral unions, various sector federations, and one after another, they are coming on strikes facing this government. Not only how much time has passed, hardly 8 months have passed, and several of the successful strikes have happened of various sectors. That's why with this confidence, definitely with the determination and firmness, with a sense of pride, the working class has great history. We have deep roots. Nobody can just cut our legs and say, you are rootless people. Our roots are so deep that we have to tell those sitting in the seat of power there in the center and all those people who are siding with them, we want to tell them, history has not excused Jai Chand and Ambhi. Jai Chand aur Ambhi ne gaddari ki thi Hindustan ke itihas mein. Aaj jo log RSS BJP ko defend karne ke liye, जो पॉलिटिकल फोर्सेस उनके साथ खड़ी रहेंगी वो भी जब उनको इतिहास से वाइप आउट किया जाएगा वो भी उनके साथ वाइप आउट की जाएंगी ये इस देश की जनता निर्णय लेगी इसलिए एक बार फिर AITUC की तरफ से ग्रीट करते हुए हम सेंटिनरी ईयर में हैं आप अपनी 50 इयर्स में हैं बाकी भी अपने-अपने सालों को मनाते हैं उन सब में हम एक दूसरे के साथ हैं 8 जनवरी की हड़ताल हमने कामयाब की है अब इसके बाद आपका सम्मेलन था हम इकट्ठे नहीं बैठ पाए हमारा सम्मेलन अप्रैल में है इन बिटवीन हम समय निकालेंगे सेंट्रल ट्रेड यूनियंस बैठेंगे अगला चरण लड़ाई का क्या होगा उसको हम तय करेंगे और बिल्कुल मजबूती से आगे बढ़ेंगे मैं ये सोचती हूँ कि आपके यहाँ बहुत से फैसले होंगे हमारी नज़र है उस पर कि अच्छे आंदोलन के फैसले आप लेके निकलेंगे हम भी अपने सम्मेलनों से निकलेंगे और एक साथ भी चलने की जो हमने पिछले 10 साल से मजबूती से एक प्लेटफॉर्म बना के हम आगे बढ़े हैं उस प्लेटफॉर्म को और मजबूत करते हुए आगे बढ़ते हुए इवन दोज इंडिपेंडेंट फेडरेशन एसोसिएशन जो हमारे साथ थी उसके भी बियॉन्ड जो इंडिपेंडेंट यूनियंस हैं वो भी स्ट्राइक्स में साथ आना शुरू हो चुके हैं तो ये हमारे काफिले बढ़ेंगे हमारे ताकत बढ़ेगी इस ताकत के साथ हम पूरे कॉन्फिडेंट हैं कि तुम कह रहे हो दिल्ली में बैठ के कि हम तो 50 साल तक राज करेंगे इन सपनों को तुम लेते रहो मोदी जी झोला लेके आए थे आप बोलते हो मैं तो झोला लेके आया हूँ मैं तो फकीर हूँ घर चला जाऊँगा तो मेरा उनसे कहना है घर जाने की तैयारी करो अपने झोले में जो डालना है डालना शुरू करो वर्किंग क्लास मैदान में है दूसरे हिस्से मैदान में उतरेंगे इस हड़ताल में भी उतरे थे किसान मजदूर और छात्र हम सब इकट्ठा हो गए थे ये इकट्ठा होने की प्रक्रिया आगे बढ़ेगी एंड डेफिनेटली वी विल सी टू इट दैट अवर ग्रेट कंट्री इंडिया इट्स हार्मनी इट्स यूनिटी इट्स लिविंग पीसफुली अमंग्स ऑल सिटीजन्स बिकॉज वी टेक प्राइड India is the only country in the whole world. I am claiming India is the only country in the whole world which has people of all faiths and beliefs in the world. We are the only country as a house, and we have pride in that. With diverse culture, diverse languages, diverse religious belief, we are a great nation, and we will save that great nation, and we will save our Indian constitution also, and our rights of unionizing, defending hard-won rights of our labor, labor rights, labor laws, everything. We will move ahead, save our public sector also, government sector also, and in that unison, with understanding of that kind, we will definitely march on. I am confident good results to come from this conference, and I greet on behalf of AITUC once again for fruitful, successful conference of CITU's 16th conference. Thank you, comrades, for listening to me.